Hello, my internet friends, and thank you so much for joining me this week. If you are new to this channel, welcome. And if you're not already subscribed, just click below and subscribe. I do put out new videos and new DIYs every week. Today's DIY is awesome because they're Easter basket cupcakes, which are grocery store cupcakes, but dressed up. So you'll feel like a total Pinterest mom in the end. Or if you're not a mom and you just want to show off to your friends, well, you got that too. So let's get started.
So you're gonna need some coconut flakes, it doesn't matter if it's sweetened or unsweetened, and some food coloring. In a small bowl, you're going to add a small amount of water, and you're going to add some drops of food coloring. You can add as many as you want, it all depends on how intense you want the grass to look. So after you've mixed everything up, you just add your coconut flakes and make sure that everything is coated. So then you're going to take your coconut flakes and you're going to strain them to get all of that water out. And then you're going to lay it down on a parchment sheet or wherever you want to just set it to dry. So now while that's drying, you can go ahead and start making your cupcakes. And I just made regular box cupcakes. And what I did was I took the stackable Easter eggs from Dollar Tree and I used the bottom to hold my cupcakes in. So once they were done, I just took my entire cupcake and I wedged it in. And a lot of it is showing, and that's okay. So now for the frosting, I just used this can of frosting from Dollar Tree, and I added the food coloring directly into the can, and I mixed it up until I got a nice green. So then I grabbed a piping bag, and I put it into a cup. It has one of the piping tips that I used in one of my previous videos, which is also from Dollar Tree. So I poured this directly into the cup, and as you can see, the frosting is really, really runny. So I do end up chilling this in the refrigerator before using, just so it doesn't slide off of my cupcake. So I just removed it from the cup and pushed it all the way down to make sure that there's no air bubbles, and I chilled it before using. So then, now that it's chilled, I did cut off the tip and I piped around my cupcake. I did not do a very neat job because the piping does not matter since you're going to cover it up with your coconut flakes. So now I brought back my coconut flakes and I added it directly onto the frosting, making sure that some of it looks like it is spilling over so that it covers the mint frosting. So I grabbed some Peeps and I cut off the heads with some kitchen shears. And I know that sounds a little bit morbid, but you're going to want to do it with kitchen shears and not with a knife so that they don't crumble. So you're going to place these right in that little gap that you left that wasn't frosted. As you can tell, when I was frosting, I left the middle plain. So now with some Twizzlers, since they have that little hole on each side, I grabbed two toothpicks and put them on each side of the bunny. And then I fed the Twizzlers through. And this is going to be the handle for the basket. So now to add a little bit more details, I did add some little tiny eggs. And you guys can add whatever you want to your beautiful cupcakes. And that's it, guys. You just made some awesome Easter basket cupcakes.
I really hope you guys enjoyed that DIY. If you do try this at home, please tag me on Instagram at PB&J and let me know how easy this was for you guys to make at home. Again, thank you so much for spending this time with me. Thank you for all the love and the support. See you next week, guys.